How long has this RBC been here? How many years?
Oh, it's a good question. Wow.
3 years?
Mais combien de temps que le RBC est ici?
11 years. RBC has been in Luxembourg 11 years. This building?
Yes. 10 years.
Okay.
At 11,
it
was 1 year in the Luxembourg city.
Oh, and then it moved to
Asheville.
No, no, it's just like I was, I had a really good job in Front Street, downtown Toronto, and I was in Germany and I worked for SAP. That was in Munich, and then I moved to Cologne and I got all my my information stolen. So I need to get all my references back for... No. No, to be honest with you, they didn't pay me, they didn't pay my health insurance. Yeah, I mean, I worked for Sky Sports. They didn't pay my health insurance, they didn't pay me. I got a lawyer and took the money.
So really?
They, yeah, so it was up in Pontefract. And then they kept, every time I kept trying to solve the situation, they would speak in German, so I don't understand. And then I worked for SAP on Nymphenburger Straße. They screwed up my my tax code. They didn't pay my car insurance.
Yeah.
They didn't pay me. And then I was supposed to go to the Arbeitsgericht because they owed me a lot of money. And then that's when I got all my stuff stolen. So I never made the court. So it was about, I had like my clothes stolen. I had 4 terabytes of information stolen, my USBs. I couldn't, my court date was supposed to be in Munich. And any time I tried to resolve it, they would speak in English, and then halfway through the sentence, they would revert to German, saying, I don't know what you're saying. So I was just against a brick wall, because then I had lawyers around, and it was just a disaster.
So
you're
going
to
move on now?
Yeah, no. I'm trying to get a new job here, but I need to get all the references back for my time in Canada. And so I worked for Bank of America, Formula One. So yeah, it was ugly, I'll be honest, in Munich. Because I went there in 2016.
Yeah.
And they had drugs inside. Well, what happened was at SAP they had like the refrigerator, cocaine, crack, drugs. So really, my boss had a desk, and when he rang the bell, my client was Volkswagen. If I didn't run to the fridge and take something, I'm fired. I'm not a team player. He was a Persian guy. He called him the terrorist. I was called a bitch. So I had to set up dev environments for Volkswagen. He would like delete them during the night, make it look like I don't know what I'm doing. He gave me an Apple Mac instead of a laptop, and the Apple Mac's not compatible with any of the training.
Mm-hmm.
And it got worse and worse and worse, and I started to receive emails from Canada, from Poland, all over the world, saying, you know what's going on there, but there's nothing you can do. I took all the videos and everything of that was going on, snippets, and I took it to Heidelberg, and they said it was too dangerous for you to go there. It was a mass mobbing, right?
Yeah,
This guy was making sexual references to women. You had to buy a crate of beer every 2 days or you're fired. So when we went to lunch, he would just drink beer. And basically, the SAP backed him and said it's too dangerous to go on cranking gal. And I said, but I'm not sick. So we said, so this went on. And then 1 week before I was supposed to go to Arbeitsgericht, I got all my stuff stolen. So I've never been in a work environment like that before. Oh, this refrigerator was loaded. It had absinthe, crack, cocaine. I remember being up there at whilst I was doing my job at 11 o'clock in the morning. I was totally wasted on gas. I could send an email. And it got to the point where if I called in soccer and football, I'm fine. And he would do it right in front of HR. HR knew what he was doing. The refrigerator was right there on Nymphenburger Straße. And they turned it on me. So, I mean, I'm a senior IT manager. He was only my boss, and he was getting away with all kinds of stuff. Like, there was a Polish girl at work. But he would call you by your name. He would give you like
make
it sexual references to female. He was about 50, this girl was like 19. So that's just real, man. I have evidence of everything. I spent 9 to 5 in Heidelberg, giving them all the evidence. I have videos, pictures, nothing. Well, did I actually report every employer has a working council, yes. The SAP working council says, if you tell anyone what's going on with the SAP, you will not protect you. But that's not what the case said. And then it got worse and nasty and nasty and nasty, and then I just left. I'm not going to tell you everything, but I mean, it was bad. Really bad. So they owe me like hundreds of thousands of euros. Oh yeah, we're not talking like nothing. They really came after me. And I've been in IT for 17 years, and they pretty much tried to destroy me because if it came out what SAP was doing. No, he was just like nasty. He was a drunk. So he must have known somebody. But the thing is, I couldn't believe he was doing it in front of HR. So it was SAP hybrids. HR would be right there, and he would just do whatever he wanted. So what I used to do was I put my headphones on and just blank him out. One day he came back and he said, this person came back from Australia, this person came back from Poland, I'm going to find this bitch. And I said, that's it. So I took my stuff. Once working council said, we will not protect you, it became violent. So my friend in Bonn said, just leave. I tried to fight them. I did everything legally correct, and they just destroyed me. It was, it's difficult to explain. How am I going to tell you anything that's going to happen? That was refrigerator alone. People told me wasted at the desk, no idea what they're doing. So this is basically because of what SAP did, that my new employer just wants to make sure I've got all my things checked and ticked for me. Sorry? Well, not yet, but I have to, if I get my references, maybe. But because of what happened at SAP, they want to make sure everything previous was okay. But it was disgusting. I should have stayed at RBC, really, to be honest, but I chanced my luck in Germany, and it was just brutal. Really brutal. Because they were supposed to send me for German lessons as well, they didn't. So when that legal scenario happened, I had 7 lawyers in Germany. I had 4 in Trier, 1 in Cologne, 1 in Munich. No, they would all say, yes, Mr. Fraser, you're right. And then when it got to the point of getting to the court, they'd be like, you speak English, it's all the way in Munich, I'm not your lawyer. But they'd already taken my money. There was just nothing I can do. It was me against a huge company. I couldn't do anything. I fought them for like a good 8-9 months, and it just got so ugly, I'm like, I can't do it anymore. So that's why I need Cyril, just to confirm that I worked at RBC. I don't know, I thought he was coming down straight away, so I can give him my resume. Okay.
He's coming.
I don't think it should be that difficult to get the HR to HR should be quite easy. Shouldn't be a big deal. No, I know my boss, Anakin Longkar. I'm pretty sure he doesn't work there anymore. I think he works for like Loblaws or something, but...
We have a name for that?
Yeah, it was Anakin Longkar. Anakin, he was Indian.
Ah, he was Indian.
Yes. Anakin Longkar. But I don't think he works there anymore. I think he works for Loblaws or something.
Je vais chercher les filles, je vais ramener le chat chez le vétérinaire, il faut que j'aille à la brosse. Ah,
bah oui.
Allez,
bonne après-midi.
Bon, je vais
donner
ma commande.
Oh, the other one was. His name was Andrew Gascoigne, right? My boss?
Yeah.